Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. It's Lauren. Thank you so much for watching. Today we're gonna be doing a makeup I'm not surprised is on sale video. This is basically where I go through and I just roast the sales section of makeup. First off, quarantine hair is really, it's killing me right now. But segue into, I feel like we're gonna see a lot more stuff go on sale. I think we're gonna see a lot of sales happening, especially with like the current economic climate. So I want to start this video off and just be like, you guys, it's not bad that makeup necessarily goes on sale, but I do think that sale makeup can be an indicator that it didn't sell well, that it is something that maybe not everyone liked as much as some of the other products. If a makeup item is super duper popular, it doesn't need a sale price to move it. And so kind of the premise of the video and the title is that if this makeup makes it to the sale page, if it makes it there, a lot of the times that means that for some reason people aren't buying it either as much then or after it's been out a while. And you know we had to hit up the Sephora sale page for this sale. I think the sale ends today. I think that's when it ends. They change up the dates for different people and their statuses, and then they also change up the percentage for different people. I don't know what you have. Check your own stats, figure out your situation. I kind of don't care about the Sephora sales that much. I try not to get too involved in them anymore because it's really not that big of a discount, and I find that I can get that same discount if I just shopped on a brand's website individually, usually like with a introductory email sign up or something. Anyway, what I'm trying to say is we're gonna be roasting Sephora sale page and it's gonna be fun, and I hope you guys just have a low key fun time, and maybe this will alert you to some deals that were on sale and it's something you really wanted. I think buying sale makeup, something that you actually have wanted for a long time and then can happen to get a discount on, that's freaking awesome. That's like the best scenario. So maybe that can be helpful. Anyway, it's just fun to just talk a little bit of shit, but like lighthearted. Kind of lighthearted, but kind of fun. Sassy is what I call it. It's sassy. All right, let's just get into it before my hair turns out even worse than it is. I will say that in this sale, we had our normal culprits in the sale section, things that I've talked about in the past, but there were some surprises. There were some surprises. I noticed a lot of Tom Ford Beauty, a lot of Marc Jacobs stuff, and also quite a bit of Viseart, and I feel like that isn't always the case, so that was kind of nice to see in the sale section. But you want it, you guys. You wanna know the big thing that wasn't there that I was so shocked? The House of Lashes palettes are gone. They're not on the sale site. I don't know where they went. They probably got shipped off to like Nordstrom Rack or something, but oh my gosh, finally. If you guys have been here a while, I'm so sorry to like not get straight into the video, but I have made a video in the past talking about sale makeup at Sephora and how they've had cream products on there for a long time. So long, so long, years and years and years. I did like a video where I researched it and I showed when they launched and the fact that they were still on the site after like 3+ years, still being sold, barely discounted, it felt like, especially for how old they were. And they actually removed the products because of that video. So anyway, I thought I would just update you that like the House of Lashes palettes are no longer there for all of y'all who always see those. They're not there anymore. They're gone. They're gone. Hopefully they don't pop up after the sale somewhere. I hope that doesn't happen. I was just so ecstatic when I went through the entire sale section and was like, wait, I didn't see the House of Lashes palettes. Am I okay? Do I have a fever? Do I need to check myself out? Like, what's going on? They're not there. Anyway, okay, we'll get into it actually now. Sorry. First thing on my list, things I'm not surprised are on sale. This is from Sol de Janeiro. You guys know, one of my favorite brands. Just because I like a brand doesn't mean it's not gonna go on here. Just because I like a product doesn't mean it's not gonna go on this list. I can understand that shit I like, not everyone will want. This is the Glow Motions Glow Body Oil, and only certain colors are actually on sale, but they are normally $35 down to $20. And the two that are still full price are probably the most popular shades. So this is something you see commonly with things that go on sale. You'll see that like an item maybe you want is on sale and you're like so excited. You go click on it and then it's only certain shades that like no one wants. You're like, dang it, the one I wanted, it's not on sale. That's kind of the situation. I definitely can see that the three shades are probably the least selling shades and the other two will eventually maybe be the only two that they keep on. Or maybe it's just like a momentary deal, who knows? I don't know, brands do different things for marking products down. The reason that I'm not surprised these are on sale is because I don't think that they got the hype. I really don't. So many brands have come out with like glowy, shimmery body oil type products. They are very, very popular, especially around summertime, but these have been out about a year now, I believe, at least. And one of the shades in there is like this prismatic kind of multi-chrome color. And on the body, it's not super noticeable, but it's definitely not selling that tans, tropical beach, Fiji, Bali vibes. It's not serving that necessarily. necessarily. And I actually have this product, so I kind of know that it's not really, I mean, it's gonna give you shimmer, but it doesn't sell the fantasy to me as well as some of those more bronze colors do. And besides that, besides like just these colors being on sale, probably the least popular ones, I also just feel like formula wise, this is like an interesting thing. They call it an oil, but really I'd call it like a gel oil. It's not super liquidy, and I think it'd almost be better for it if it was, because it could just, I don't know, I think it would sell the fantasy better. This is just this weird kind of, I don't know, I didn't like the texture. I didn't love the texture. It wasn't like a lotion, but it also wasn't like an oil. It was this weird in-between gel-like thing, and I think that texturally it could be better. And I think that, you know, with so many options on the market, there are a lot of different brands, either lower end or higher end or in the same price range, doing this type of product that I think might be selling this fantasy better, which is unfortunate because I think that Sol de Janeiro, like, this is like a perfect product for what they do. I don't know, maybe it was a little off, and I was so excited for this product, honestly. I was at the time, but actually having it, actually using it, I could see why it's not maybe the most popular one on the market and maybe why it's on sale. Maybe that's a reason. Moving on, next product on my list is from Melt, and this is the Impulsive Palette. This retails for $65. It's down to $32.50, a really great lowered price. This is half off, and who knows if that will be just for the sale, if it will just be for a moment, or if it's more of like a permanent markdown until they sell out. It's kind of weird because this is the only palette from Melt that really is out of their either stack form or their new like longer palette form. This is its own weird thing. And although I do like seeing innovation, it definitely felt a little off to me at the time when it came out. I think this got decent reviews, but I'm not surprised to see it there. I don't think I really heard much about it, you know, after launch. It was like hot for a minute, you know how products are. And then since then, I don't feel like I hear people constantly reaching for it or using it. It doesn't feel as classic as some of their other palettes like the Gemini, or even how I imagine the Rust, like the new Rust palette that's come out, how that will be more of a classic. I can see people buying that for a long time. It's such like a staple palette to have in a range. It just felt a little off for them, but I was excited initially about it because it was like one of the first things coming out, I think, at Sephora once they had been sold there. So it felt like this whole new thing, like they're at Sephora now and now there's the Impulsive palette, but it's just kind of a chunky, weird guy. I don't know. Not surprised though. That's all I gotta say. Not surprised it's there. And I think if it was something you wanted, this is such a great time to get it on a great deal that you don't have to spend almost $70. You can spend a little over $30 and get the palette and try the formula, especially if you are someone who loves Melt's formula. So that is a positive. That's a positive, guys, okay? You can do it. All right, moving on. Next from Marc Jacobs, this is the Omega Glaze It All Over Highlighter. This one came out during Christmas, like for holiday. I actually really wanted this highlighter. I was like so excited. I thought it looked so beautiful. And I was like, maybe this will be the time that I splurge on a Marc Jacobs highlighter. And then I saw some reviews. I specifically remember seeing Mel Thompson's review on this. And I'm pretty sure she did not give it a good review. And I was like, oh my gosh, if she doesn't like it, then it must be like, there's no way I can make it work. I don't think I can, like, it's not going to be worth the money. And just seeing it in the sale page now, I think that a lot of people were disappointed from this. From what I can remember, I think the formula was a little bit more like chunky sparkly than people were expecting. Like they wanted something more smooth and just glowy and so pretty, and it had so much potential. It had so much potential, but I don't think formula wise it lived up. It originally retailed for $49 and now it's down to $29 if you were, you know, are a gambling woman and you want to go try it out. Highly don't suggest that probably, but it is cheaper. Let me know if you were someone who really liked that or if you tried it and didn't. I'd love to kind of get an opinion on that one in the comments. Moving on, I have some products from Kaja on here. I have a couple different reasons for not being surprised these are on the sale page. The first one is the Roll-On Highlighting Balm. This retails originally for $28. It's down to $14, so it's half off. I'm not surprised to see this on sale because this is one of Kaja's gimmicky products and they do gimmicks. Like, I think Kaja is definitely not afraid of the gimmick. They like to have the little heart blush, the star bronzers, the moon highlighters, but something about that works as in it's cute and still pretty functional. This I don't think is. I actually have this product because I got it off of BoxyCharm's pop-up sale. So I think I got it for like $7 or something. So like half of what this half off price is. So I got it for like a fourth of the price. I just couldn't resist, you guys. I couldn't resist, okay? I was like, it's so cheap. Even if I don't like it, at least I'm not out a ton of money. I'm hoping that it will be something I like. Like everything seems besides the gimmick to be something I would. And it just doesn't, it's just not a super like dewy, glowy highlighter in the way that I want. So product wise, it doesn't even really perform to me, on top of this weird gimmick that I don't even think helps make the product work or be more functional. It's just like the world's craziest highlighter. Do you remember when those videos were going on? It's perfect for that video. It's perfect for that video. Like, what, it rules? But other than that, it's not for everyday use. It feels like it was a product made to just have a video on for people to watch for entertainment, not for real use. So that's why I'm not surprised it's on sale. And then I'm also not surprised, I guess, because I did see it at the Boxy pop-up. One of the perks of like having a BoxyCharm membership is that every once in a while, which I feel like they're doing them more often than I've seen them do it in the past, they'll do these pop-up sales where either products that have been in the boxes in the past or maybe some newer products will be really, really low discounted. And so that product was in there, but the next product from Kaja was also on the sale page. This is the Kaja Dream Puff Radiant Primer. It retails for $26, it's down to $19, but I've seen both of these items now from Kaja in that sale. And so I'm not surprised when other retailers follow suit and put these products on sale. It just feels like, oh, it's their time to go now. Like either they didn't sell well or it's just time to bring a new product and like move out old stock. So that's one of the reasons adding to this Radiant Primer that I'm not surprised it's on sale. Again, this one also seems a little gimmicky, like having it foam up and do all this, like being in a form that's so different. It just isn't necessary, I don't think. I think Kaja has established itself enough now that it doesn't necessarily need that. It could just come out with a glowy primer and people would want it. Like, at least I would. I like Kaja, so I don't think they need to go too different necessarily. Like, they've made enough of an impact and they're known enough now. They can just like have a little gimmick, but still keep it functional, still keep it, you know, workable. All right, moving on. Another kind of similar one is from Touch and Soul. There are two products that I want to talk about. Another brand I really like. I like Touch and Soul stuff. They're definitely my style. It's that K-beauty type brand. I love that. I love that it's like light coverage and sparkles. Like, I love that. But there are the Touch and Soul. These are like, oh, they're in a pot. It's like it's the Metalist eyeshadow pigment, whatever. I'm actually kind of sad that I didn't notice it went on sale earlier because I would have bought Hollow Mulberry. I would have bought it. I have two of them. They did send me those in PR and I love them. And I would have actually bought the Hollow Mulberry full price. I would have bought it full price. But I just feel Touch and Soul for some reason just doesn't get as much recognition. I don't think people talk about the brand enough, but I have tried a lot of their products and I do think that they're really good. So I think that's part of the reason that these went on sale. There's also like weird stuff I've noticed between like Sephora carrying Touch and Soul and Ulta carrying Touch and Soul, and they don't carry some of the same products. Like, it almost feels like their line and like the range of products that they carry has been split between the two sites. I think most of them do not overlap, and so maybe that's part of why this is on sale and like why I'm not surprised it's on sale, because they don't carry even all of Touch and Soul stuff, which I wish that one, at least one, did. So if you were gonna try it, you could buy multiple things. I don't know, that was just something I noticed, and I was like, you know, coming up with conspiracy theories of like why this might be on sale, and I was like, well, maybe their contract's up with Sephora now and they're just gonna be at Ulta, or maybe something like that's going on. Maybe not, but maybe, I don't know. I'm just not surprised, I guess, ultimately. Even though these are so beautiful, I did notice they were all sold out. So I hope everyone who bought them like loves them, because they're so beautiful. They're so sparkly, beautiful little potted eyeshadows. I really wish I got the Mulberry one. It makes me sad that I didn't, but I still want to buy that eventually, even if I don't get a deal on it. Okay, anyway, the other Touch and Soul product that's on here, this is the matte-ish liquid eyeshadows. These, I'm not surprised they're on sale because of everything I already talked about with Touch and Soul, but also because, again, these were on the BoxyCharm Boxy pop-up sale. I got one as PR, but I also have bought one, and I got them for like $4 on the BoxyCharm pop-up sale. Right now, I think they're selling for $11. They're originally $16. So again, I'm not surprised Sephora's following suit and putting these on sale, but I will say, if you were someone who's tempted by the Glossier like matte liquid eyeshadows, these are like very similar to me in color. I've talked about this, but they're very similar in color and just style. So if you really, really wanted to try them, I would try out the Touch and Soul ones. Maybe you can find and like, you know, search the internet and see if you can find them for even cheaper than the $11 on Sephora site. But yeah, not surprised to see them there when I was getting them for such a steal of a deal. And even then with the Boxy sale, sometimes things sell out really fast and sometimes things don't. And they were just on there forever. Like at $4, they still were not selling out. So I think maybe people don't really want a matte liquid eyeshadow. I don't know. I was surprised to see because it's such a cheap, like $4 for any makeup product is pretty inexpensive. And then for a product that initially retailed for almost $20, that's like a really good discount. It's pretty steep. So anyway, I'm talking about the BoxyCharm pop-up so much. I should do one of these on that. Like products I'm not surprised to see in the Boxy pop-up and why. That'd be a good one. Let me know if you'd be interested. Okay, moving on. Only a couple more to talk about. I have a product here from Lunar Beauty. The Strawberry Dreams palette is on sale. Originally, it retailed for $48. It's on sale for $29. And this is no shade to Manny, to his brand. I think that the Strawberry Dreams palette was a pretty solid launch. I think that Lunar Beauty has only gotten better with their launches. I'm actually excited when they launch stuff. I'm excited to see what the vision is, what the items are gonna be, what the palettes look like inside. And I don't think that this was a bad palette. I just think this is an example that like when things are hot, they're hot, and when they're not, they're not. And this palette came out a little bit ago. I think people that are gonna buy it have already bought it, and now it's time to put it on sale and to move it so that more people will buy it and finish getting rid of that stock. And that's a lot of the beauty industry and a lot of industries. When it's really focused on the next new thing, that's what happens. Products where there's still leftover stock after that initial hype has died away usually tend to go on sale so that you can get that last little push of that product out of the store, out of the shelves, so you can move new, fresh product on them and it's like gone, you know? So I'm not surprised to see it there, but it's great if you did want that palette to be able to get a discount on it. Second to last product I wanted to talk about, this is from KVD Vegan Beauty. I still always want to say Kat Von D, but it's not. KVD Vegan Beauty. This is the True Portrait Shake Foundation. Originally $37, it's down to $24. And I'm not surprised to see this because I really think it's going to be an uphill battle for KVD Vegan Beauty to come back. This product launched when Kat Von D was still a part of the company and everything. And I think that, you know, just with everything that was going on and all of it, I'm exhausted to think about it, honestly. It's too much for me right now. But I don't think that it got a really good launch. Personally, I think that the product looks pretty. I like that it's a more medium coverage, lighter coverage. I think it complemented the other foundation that they had really well because that one was so matte and full coverage. I think it was a smart move to offer another foundation for people who don't want that, but I just think timing was really bad. I think a whole rebrand is gonna be needed to me. If they were coming to me for advice, why would they? I don't know. But if they were, what I would say is that I think that they should just either drop it or, I mean, really, really rebrand. And I know that's tough, but I think it's going to be a lot of time before they're able to really get things going. And I think they're going to need to relaunch stuff in this new form before even that can start happening. And so I could see this had a great shade range, I thought too. Like, it feels very on trend in so many ways and could be so popular, but I think it was just bad timing of when this actually did come out. It didn't get the initial hype. I don't think that the rebrand is going particularly swimmingly. It's not like the worst, but it could be better, I guess. I don't know. Let me know what you guys think. Are you buying from KVD Beauty or not? I'd love to know. Okay, and last on here, I just wanted to talk about all of the hair accessories that are on Sephora's sale page. I don't know about you, but when I go to Sephora, I am there to get my fix of makeup, okay? I want my makeup. I do not want hair stuff. So I'm not surprised to see hair accessories or really anything that's not makeup on the sale page. I remember doing one of these videos and like Google Home was on the sale page. I'm like, why would Sephora sell Google Home? This makes no sense to me. What is happening? Like, people don't go to Sephora for Google Home. Not that I guess they couldn't, because if you sell it, they could buy it, but it's just not why people are there. And I know that Sephora sells hair products, so it's not quite the same as the Google Home, but at least for me, in my experience and how I am as a shopper, I'm not there to get these accessories. It feels just like so overpriced to be overpriced. If I'm gonna pay for a really expensive hair accessory, I'm going to like buy it from a really high-end brand that just is happening to do hair accessories. Or, I mean, what am I talking about? I have four hairs, so I'm really not doing it. I've actually bought these barrettes. They're just like big barrettes trying to be Dua Lipa, and it just doesn't work for me. I can't make it work. I try to do the, like, you know how they do the barrettes like this? Oh my God, I look ridiculous when I do it. But they have the ones that are like the words in the rhinestone and whatnot, and I just feel like if people are buying these, they're just not buying them from Sephora. This is just my theory again. All this is my theory and opinion, hello. But I just don't feel like they're buying it from Sephora. And also, they're probably just gonna get it the cheapest that they possibly can because it's more of like a trendy item at the moment. Or they're gonna be like rich as hell and just get like real diamonds to do it. You know what I mean? Like, why would you spend about $30 on it? There's some hair scrunchies on there that I'm like, what the hell? so much money for a hair scrunchie, and they're not even like silk. I don't get it. I don't get it. I don't know. Maybe I just don't understand because I don't have hair. Like, that could be totally it. That's probably it, actually. That's probably what it is. All right, don't worry about me just getting rid of my white line like I always have to do. Anyway, guys, I hope you enjoyed the video. I hope you had a little bit of fun being a little sassy, talking about those sale items. I'm not surprised to see there. Let me know what you picked up on the sale page or just from the sale in general. Do you like it? Do you not? Let us know what you think down in the comments. And other than that, I will see you guys in my next video. Bye!